Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to welcome all of you to the State Department's Tree Room, and thank you for coming. I know we have a number of our colleagues from the Department of State, the NSC, the Department of Energy, as well as the Nuclear Regulatory Commission, and other industry leaders who are here with us today, so thank you very much for attending. We are here today to bring into force the United States-United Arab Emirates Agreement for Peaceful Nuclear Cooperation through the exchange of diplomatic notes between the U.S. Undersecretary of State for Arms Control and International Security, the Honorable Ellen Tauscher, and the Ambassador of the United Arab Emirates to the United States, His Excellency Yusuf Al-Otaiba. Once in force, the agreement will establish the legal framework for the United States to engage in civil nuclear cooperation with the UAE under agreed non-proliferation conditions and controls. By bringing this agreement into force, the United States and the UAE are taking an important step in building a partnership to enhance non-proliferation and energy security in the Middle East region. And now, Undersecretary of State Ellen Tauscher and the Ambassador of the UAE will initial exchange the notes bringing the agreement into force. The Undersecretary will now deliver brief remarks.
Thank you very much. I want to thank everyone for being here, and welcome to all of the members of the State Department family who have worked so hard with our dear friends from the United Arab Emirates to have this very, very wonderful celebration today. Ambassador Otaiba, thank you so much for your hard work and leadership and for joining us here for this celebration at the State Department. I want to acknowledge our guests from the United Arab Emirates, our ambassadors, and my fellow diplomats. In Prague earlier this spring, President Obama set forth a goal of achieving the peace and security of the world without nuclear weapons. He admitted that achieving this goal will take patience and persistence, and that it might not happen in our lifetime. But I believe that the journey and the concrete steps that we take to reduce our nuclear stockpiles and curb and stop the proliferation of nuclear weapons and material is as important as the goal itself. So it brings me great personal pleasure to bring into force the United States-United Arab Emirates Agreement for Peaceful Nuclear Cooperation. In today's world, we must find ways to meet the demand for clean energy and to recognize the right of all nations to pursue the peaceful use of nuclear power. But we need to achieve this balance without increasing the risk of proliferation of nuclear weapons and material. This agreement, the first of its kind, will allow cooperation with the UAE in meeting domestic energy needs in a manner reflecting a strong commitment to the highest standards of nuclear safety, security, and non-proliferation. This agreement is a tangible expression of the United States' desire for close cooperation with the UAE, and it is part of a strong and mutually beneficial political, security, and economic relationship. I should note that the UAE is a valued partner in our efforts in Afghanistan, Iraq, and Pakistan, as well as our efforts to prevent Iran from obtaining nuclear weapons capability. As expressed in the agreement, the UAE is choosing to pursue nuclear power via the import of nuclear fuel, rather than developing expensive and proliferation-sensitive fuel cycle technologies, such as uranium enrichment and reprocessing. In doing so, the UAE will adhere to the highest IAEA safeguards. This is a new bargain for the Middle East region, and the United States welcomes and applauds the UAE's decision. The United States industry is already contributing to the development of nuclear power programs in the UAE, and this agreement will facilitate further involvement. We believe our technology is the best in the world, and we hope that the UAE will give it strong consideration as it moves forward in implementing its plans. On a personal note, I would like to add that it has been a great pleasure working with the UAE and the ambassador on this agreement. The UAE government has shown notable flexibility with both the substance of the agreement and some with our somewhat lengthy bureaucratic process. The result is an agreement that both nations can be very proud and very pleased with. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Madam Secretary. Thank you. I'm delighted to be here today as the agreement on peaceful nuclear energy cooperation between our two countries enters into force. This agreement supports a new global gold standard for the development of peaceful civilian nuclear energy by countries that need nuclear energy for their economic development. The UAE nuclear energy program is peaceful by design, developed with international agencies and other responsible governments, including the United States. Our responsibility is to ensure that the UAE will be successful in meeting the country's growing need for electricity while at the same time eliminating the risk of proliferation. The UAE has made a commitment not to enrich uranium or reprocess spent fuel, which means that the UAE will not house these sensitive technologies. These commitments are enshrined in the agreement, the first time the United States has included them in a bilateral civilian nuclear agreement. We've also signed the IAEA's additional protocol, which ensures the most stringent inspections regime. And we made these commitments to demonstrate our peaceful goals and to remove any ambiguity about our intentions. The UAE model will become even more important as the world grapples with how to enforce and strengthen the non-proliferation regime. Finally, I want to note that this agreement enhances the already deep relationship between our two countries. And I want to acknowledge the Obama administration for its support to the agreement, and especially to Secretary Clinton and to Undersecretary Tucker. I'd also like to offer my appreciation to both Chairman Berman and Chairman Kerry for their leadership in facilitating the congressional review of the agreement. And finally, I'd also like to extend my thanks to Secretary Rice and her team, with whom we began this process more than 2 years ago. With this and other international agreements, and with the upcoming commercial selection, the UAE will move forward with a civilian nuclear energy program. And as we do, we look forward to expanding our partnerships with a range of U.S. companies, experts, and government officials, which represents the highest standards of safety, security, transparency, and non-proliferation. Together, we can show the world that countries can gain from the benefits of peaceful nuclear energy while preserving global security. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes our ceremony. Thank you very much again for joining us for this important and historic occasion, and we hope to see you soon.